Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am super excited today to talk to you again about Silhouette Studio. Now, what we're going to talk about today is very important, whether you are a new beginner or an experienced user, and it is going to be your default settings. Okay, now I know that doesn't sound very exciting, but I promise it is. It is some very useful information, and let's go ahead and get started.
So in Silhouette Studio, when I'm talking about default settings, you know, obviously the system, the software has a certain set of defaults that come standard when you install the software. Now that's normal. Every software is like that. What I'm here to tell you about is that there are some of these defaults that I can change. And I call them defaults. Maybe I'm calling them the wrong thing. They're actually referred to as preferences. And I want you to look all the way down in the right-hand side of your software, and you'll see a little gear. All right, this is settings gear, and it says open preferences panel. Now, you can also use a shortcut on your keyboard that is Control K for Windows, and will most likely be Command K if you're on a Mac, but you can go to Edit and Preferences. It's going to take you the same place. Now, in the Preferences window, you have your main view here, and then along the top, you have a whole lot of different icons. So let's go through those. We are not going to go through each one individually. We will touch on them, and then I will highlight what I consider the most important ones to pay attention to. Now, the first one that I want to point out is going to be under the General menu, and it's going to be your default save location. In my opinion, do make sure that that is set to hard disk. Now, that is going to default the save location to your computer. And if you have watched any of my Silhouette Studio or SVG organization videos, then this will be up to you to make your own decision. But in my opinion, I save all of my files to my hard disk, and so there I will have that as my default location. You also have a unit of measurement. Now I'm based in the US, I do have inches selected. And then print resolution is defaulted to 600 DPI. I left it there, but depending on if you print a lot from Silhouette Studio and you know what you're looking at as far as the type of print resolution you need, then this is where you could potentially change that. So up here, we are going to switch over to the next icon, which is defaults. We have page orientation, choose automatically. Now I'm going to select portrait because nine times out of 10, I am trying to print and or cut in a portrait format. Now, of course, I can still change this if I want to on individual projects, but it will start off being in the portrait format. For my blade type, I am going to select the default to ratchet blade. Now, you know, I started back, we'll call them the olden days. I started with the ratchet blade, and maybe I'm just old school. I did not convert well to the auto blade. And I know that a lot of beginners have problems with the auto blade. And just to let you in on a little tip, the ratchet blade is more cost effective. Cost effective is a nice way of saying it's cheaper. So it is about half the price of an auto blade. So any of you frugal crafters out there, if you haven't heard of this option already, check into the ratchet blade. But it means that the Cameo will not adjust it for you. And to save a little bit of money, you have to update the blade settings yourself. I don't know if that's worth it for you, but just know that it's out there. Now, default fill style. This may be important for some of you guys. I do have it set to outline only, and I will leave it on outline only. That's what I'm used to, but you can actually have it set to fill. What this is when you type out text or when you draw a shape and you only receive the red outline, that is where this option is. So if you are new and you feel like this option is frustrating for you, you have a hard time moving around your items that only have a red outline, you could update that here. There are a couple other options that we have to look at. Always display mat, cut edge of page, cut to edge of page, registration marks, center rotation. I'm not going to go into detail on those. And, you know, just know that if you research these options, and these are options that you want turned on all the time, this is where you can come and you can just simply hit the checkbox. Now, I don't always use a mat. I don't want to cut to the edge of the page. I very rarely use registration marks, and the center rotation is not a big deal for me. So I'm going to leave all of those unchecked. However, I do like having the flexible panel mode. Now, what that means is that if I just select one panel, I can switch from panel to panel and it will only display one at a time. But I can start moving panels off to the side, and that will allow me to open more than one panel. Now, there are very, very few circumstances where I want to open more than one panel, so I do leave it on flexible. You can change it to single panel mode. I'll be honest with you, most people don't even know anything about flexible panel mode or that you can open more than one panel, so really you don't need to. So I would just leave it on flexible panel mode. Do not auto release connections. Now, if you have a lot of problems getting your computer to connect to your Cameo, and you leave your Cameo and your computer on all the time, and you know, a certain set of other circumstances, you can check this. And as long as your computer stays near your Cameo and you meet a certain set of conditions, your computer will always stay connected to your Cameo. Now, you know, I actually carry my laptop around a lot. I carry it around with me. So, you know, as soon as I get out of range, I'm going to disconnect anyway. So this is not really a useful option for me. This can even be the case if you travel around your house. If you pick up and walk to another room, you know, you can get around out of that Bluetooth range and then it's going to disconnect. So, but that option is there. You can try it out if you want to. I don't know that it is overly helpful. I don't find it inconvenient to connect to my Cameo. I mean, my software just does it when I'm ready to cut. So I guess you could save a few seconds, but the option is there. And then, of course, you have the option to auto-release when connections are not in use. Now, that would just mean if you're not actively cutting. So even if you're in Bluetooth range, this is the opposite of the other one. All right. So one is do not auto-release, and the other one is auto-release even more. So I don't know that either of those really matter. Display. Now, you can change your current theme from light to dark. Let me just show you. I feel that this is helpful if you work a lot in certain lighting conditions. Other than that, it would just be a preference. I do prefer to leave it on the light theme. There we go. You can also determine your background color. Let me see, you can increase your button size if you find that your buttons are difficult to see or find. You can do that. Other than that, there's not a whole lot going on the display menu. Let's click over to import. Now, I don't know of anybody regularly using GSD files anymore, but if you are, there's those options. But a lot of people do use SVG and DXF options. And here is where you can select as is. I'm going to do the SVG as is. The cut lines, now this is really, really nice because SVGs used to import and none of the cutting lines were turned on. So that led to confusion. Some people thought you had to trace them. You don't. They do default to cut all. But just know that you can change that if you want to. Convert white lines to black. I am going to do that. It's actually rare that I open an SVG with white lines, but just in case I do, because I can't see white on my cutting mat. So then that could be frustrating. I'm not going to join lines into poly lines. I'm not going to do that. And then I'm going to uncheck join lines into poly lines for DXF files. So I changed it to as is, convert white lines to black, and I'm going to uncheck join lines into poly lines. So I can go ahead and hit apply. And I do that after each one. You can either hit okay, which is what you saw when I was doing the display, or you can just come over here and hit apply. All right, tools. Here's where we get into the good stuff. So I would say you could actually skip everything else I've said until now. Not that I want you to, because it's useful information, you know, but we are 10, 11 minutes into this video. Technically, this is where like the meat of the good stuff starts. What I'm talking about is what happens in your software after you do certain things. So after creating a shape. Now, this happens to me and it still gets the best of me. I draw a square and I'm done. But my software will continue to draw more squares. Every time I click, I'm going to draw a new square until I go up and choose the select, which is my cursor. I don't like that. That's not fun for me. It's not a fun game I like to play with myself. It's frustrating. So I like it when it automatically goes back to select, because very rarely do I need to draw that shape more than one time, whether it's a rectangle, whether it's a circle. I just want to draw one and be done. And then if I need another one, I can choose the draw shape again. Same thing for freehand drawing, same thing for using the eraser, same thing for using the knife, and Zoom defaults to choose select, so that's good. And the same thing for the eyedropper, it defaults to choose select, but I like everything to be choose select. Now, this is another one, what to do when you're using your drag box, your drag selecting. It defaults, and I do prefer it to stay on select shapes touching the drag box. So that means if that shape or that text is just slightly touching the drag box, it's going to select it. I like that. But you do have the option to only select shapes that are enclosed by the box, which means you have to draw the box all the way around that shape before it becomes selected. When many shapes are selected, do you want a single bounding box or multiple bounding box? I like the single bounding box. When right-clicking subsequent shapes, do I want it a new shape become selected or the original shape remain selected? I want it to select the new shape. If I'm right-clicking on the new shape, I want it to select the new shape. Lasso style, touches are enclosed. That is going to be similar to the drag box. I want it when it touches. Now, there are a few, we'll say more advanced editing options down here. And that's going to be whether you are maintaining thick lines as lines or you're going to switch them to polygons. Now what that means is, for example, if I draw a thick line, right now it's going to default, it's still going to say, hey, that's a line. That's for when I'm cutting. It will cut a single line. Some people prefer in their designing to switch it to thick lines to polygons. What that means is a thick line will actually switch over into a rectangle. I find that confusing for myself. You know, I don't know how it works in other softwares, but that's how it works in my brain, that a line is a line when I want a rectangle to be a rectangle. Same thing with subtract and subtract all, thick lines to polygons. I like to maintain thick lines as lines. Well, it's giving me a hidden option. I actually don't remember anything else being down there. Maybe that's an error, but I can't get to it. I can't scroll to it. So if you happen to notice that down at the bottom, we're just going to breeze past that for now. Okay. All right. Now this is another one that I like to change. I want to set my check for updates monthly. Now that is because I actually do not like to update my Silhouette Studio software. I am actually running a legacy version now, which if you don't know what a legacy version is, it just means that it is a prior version of Silhouette Studio. And typically speaking, I will stay on a legacy version until Silhouette America dangles a little carrot in front of me and says, hey, if you update to, you know, 4 point whatever, whatever, then you will gain all of these extra features. That happened with version 4.2. I gained some extra features, so I updated, and then I bought a portrait 3, so I had to update to another certain level to be able to use it. And, you know, so there are plenty of reasons for updating when they release those new features. But typically speaking, it's just not something I do regularly because I get comfortable, and sometimes the new editions of Silhouette Studio will have bugs. So there's a feature that if it checks for updates and it finds a new update, it will pop up and ask you on startup, hey, there's an update. Do you want to update? And every now and then, I don't want to call it a panic, but just in the routine of clicking okay, I would click okay, and it would try to get me to update. And I'm like, no, I don't really want to play this game today. So I switched it to monthly, so it's only going to check monthly, and that's the way I like it. So not that you guys wanted all that information about me and my preferences, but I switched it to monthly. Hit apply. Now, under advanced, you do have some options. Say you go through all this and you get back to Silhouette Studio and you're like, you know what, I don't really like the different options that I selected there. You can restore factory defaults. Okay. You can restore your preloaded designs. Now, that is not a backup of your library or anything like that. Okay. You can set library permissions. I don't really know that you want to mess with all that. I don't often come to the advanced panel. I'll be honest with you, after I set these preferences, I won't even think about the default settings anymore until somebody asks me, until somebody says, hey, what about those defaults? But there is one thing here. Now, this is like story time. I'm going to tell you a story about once upon a time, a couple years ago, when Silhouette users were having problems, their machine would cut in very jagged spurts. So it was literally like cut, pause, cut, pause, cut, pause, cut, pause. And it was causing a lot of problems in their cut lines. They were very jagged. They were very ugly. People were very frustrated. And the packet size has to do, and that's what I have pulled up here, has to do with the size of the information packets that Silhouette Studio is sending to your Cameo. And I am not a software expert by any means, so I'm going off secondhand information here from years and years ago. But it is said that the packet size was sending information that was overwhelming the Cameo. And I'm not sure why, because only some people had it and other people didn't. But they were recommending that you come in here and change your packet size to 500 bytes, which is the smallest. Now, it is set automatically to 1,000. And I'll be honest with you, it has been years and years and years since I have heard of anybody needing to reduce their packet size. So if you have the capability to file that away in the very back dark recesses of your brain and potentially pull that out in the future, if you were to experience that problem, this could be a solution for you. Now, again, I don't have that problem, and I've not heard of that problem in a very long time, but there it is. And that completely concludes our tour of the preferences panel and the default settings that you may want to explore for your Cameo 4. So I just want to show you. I mean, this is amazing. Watch. I can draw a rectangle and be done. I'm not going to draw one over and over. I can do the same thing for a circle. Oh my gosh, and I'm done. So I've been waiting all day to do that so that I could show you guys the default preferences there. So, all right, guys, let's go ahead and wrap it up.
So guys, what did you think about the custom settings? Now, I know, like I said in the beginning, it's not the most exciting video you're going to watch all week, but that is very useful information, whether you are a beginner or whether you've been silhouetting for a while. So I really hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that you learned a few things. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave those below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Make video requests. Tell me what you want to see. I am more than happy to do everything I can to help you along your crafting journey. So, all right, guys, thanks again. I really appreciate it, and we'll see you next time.